if there's a log book in there, the request was to sign it. According to BLM.
Day 7 started out like you would expect after staying a night in a hotel. By the time we all got up, dusted the cobwebs out, went across the parking lot and had some breakfast at the Apple Peddler. It was after 9 a.m. The previous day, we had decided to knock some miles off the trail and take a more direct route to Crack in the Ground. We headed up the short walk to the start of the aptly named Crack in the Ground.
Come on, boys. Fan messy.
Huh? Somebody signed in from Latvia?
Wow.
Okay, this place gets busy.
Climbing rock anymore. Super cool.
After exploring Crack in the Ground, we made our way to the town of Christmas Valley to top off fuel and eat some lunch. long after that, we were back on the trail. This section of the route is pretty intense. It's rocky. Really, really rocky. Yeah, I have to say that this particular section of this route, I cannot recommend.
Unless they're trying to make a martini or something.
I mean, I guess if you were on like maybe 35s or 37s and you could air down to, and you wanted to air down to like 15 PSI or something, that might do it. You have nature somewhere. Oh, nature to the, 1 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Was that Tanya squeaking?
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, you'd have to, I mean, I could probably air down more enough to make this tolerable, but then, but you really can't, and then I wouldn't really have a good gauge as to what you that thing was going over.
You still running to your left?
I don't see it to my left. Oh yeah, way over there. Damn, that thing's fast. This is just kind of cruel for anything. I mean, I don't know, maybe some people like going down this kind of rocky thing.
I can't think a motorcycle would enjoy this.
No, I can't either. I mean, you'd have to like crawl down this.
Hey, now, the view up here is kind of pretty.
Yes, it is. I mean, this isn't even rock crawling. This is bouncing on rocks for hours. Which section is this? Is this section 4?
152.
What you doing?
Leave me alone.
Oh, that breeze feels so good though.
It's a nice little breeze, yeah.
I both like and dislike that smell.
After crawling along on this trail for hours, we decided that scrambling our brains wasn't what we had in mind for this trip. We found a trail back to the main road. Oh, this is kind of steep and rocky. Okay, I'm not getting that. Absolutely. We hit the main road and worked our way into Fremont National Forest. This is where we found that the maps that were part of the route we ordered and the maps that we brought with us were out of date. Not much was lining up. Eventually, we found a spot that we liked for setting up camp. Unfortunately, as soon as we started setting up the vehicles, we heard our neighbor, the sound of a bear making its presence known. We made the decision to move on.
Yep. He's not right here, but he's close enough. We don't want to sleep here.
Unfortunately, there were not many options presenting themselves, and it was starting to get dark. We looked at the different maps and tried to find something. We found a campground and plotted a course. During our drive to the campground, it got dark. Normally, I love this kind of dark, but not when we're trying to navigate roads with less than accurate maps. We finally found the campground. We set up camp as quickly and quietly as we could, knowing that we rolled in after 10 o'clock. We ate our dinner and hit the rack. It had been a very long, long day.